five different motor fitness components. So talk about balance, coordination, quickness, agility, and I added rhythm to it, but that's just, you don't have to do that. This is, I think rhythm is very important.
Why do you add that one?
Because if you look at it, when I put on a video, you just watch, there is a rhythm to the movement. The fast, the slow, change the pattern and movement, yeah? It's almost like, and I said it earlier to Marianne, sometimes I compare them to a ballroom dancer. Yeah?
Yeah.
All right? It's all about balance, rhythm, and combining all the different movements, yeah? And if you fall over in ballroom dancing, what do you do? What do you watch for and somebody falls over? I don't know. Then.
You just laugh.
You laugh, yeah, but now whatever. Come on. Finger skating. That ball down and somebody falls, what do they do? They get up very quick and continue and pretend nothing happened. And they pick up the rhythm and the dance again. Yeah? It's the same, you know. Your opponent tries to get you off balance. If you get you off balance, you compensate, you get back on balance, you get back into your stride, your rhythm, and the pattern of movement. Yeah, you can see the push, the turn, the jump, the slide. There's a lot of rhythm to the movement. And sometimes it slows down, sometimes it goes faster. So that's why I think rhythm is very... Somebody who's very good rhythm, yeah, will... You know, generally have very good footwork. That's why when you're teaching kids footwork or movement, it's always good to use speed ladders and get somebody into teach aerobics. You know, do dancing. I've done dancing lessons with, you know, with players just to try and get that rhythm. So that's just, and as I say, it's my personal insight that I think rhythm is important.
How would you translate that? Because like some of us are dancers here, but actually teaching that in footwork, are you talking about that as in boom, shit, boom?
you could do that, and it's all for example, you could say a combination of two shots where you're looking at a certain pattern of movement which you want to do, so you're repeating that, so it's a rhythm to it. Split, step, step, hit, split, yeah? Split, slide, slide, hit, slide, step, turn, slide, hit. You know, like kind of there's they're trying to get that, yeah. Sometimes by, yeah, is it like, yeah, it's a rhythm of it. So, is there an infinite? Yeah, there's no answer. But generally in badminton, I think when we can look at it, we can put any sort of movement that we do in this kind of eight, split step, run, just say pivot, hop, cross behind, or cross step, jump, and lunge, yeah? What is important for you guys to know which one is appropriate in which situation, depending on whether you are in a defensive situation, neutral situation, attacking situation, and whether you're playing an attacking shot, a defensive shot, a neutral shot, yeah? And what you are expecting to happen after that. And all those things make up for what movement you do, where you choose to run, where you choose to shush and slide, where you have to add a hop, which we got Brendan to do again, just to kind of, yeah? This was the movement cycle, start, approach, hit, recover, goes round and round, never ending until the rally stops. And on the 15 level, the average amount of shots per rally is only about 3.7, yeah? But when the rallies get longer and older, then... And putting it all together, yeah, looks like this. So. Hopefully that makes sense.